Hello everyone, this is the first video on the tutorial of QGIS. This is an introductory video where we will be discussing about the software and interface, and we will also be discussing about georeferencing. So I am using QGIS software here. You can use ArcGIS or Saga, and depending on that, you can perform the task. Some or the other differences will be there in commands and all. Rest of the things we can perform in all types of GIS softwares. So I'm using QGIS because it is open source and it is available to access free of cost. So first you have to download the software, type download QGIS on Google, and this window will appear. First, you choose your operating system, whether it is Windows or it is Mac or it is Linux or Ubuntu. Select which version you want to download, whether you want to download the latest release or the long-term release, which is the previous release basically. A lot of help is available on the previous releases, whereas the recent ones are still in the phase of development and people are working on it. There may be some bugs also. So I recommend to choose any of the previous versions. I have downloaded 3.1. Please select your system, operating system or configuration also, whether it is 64-bit or 32-bit. So go to all releases, check the previous releases here and download it and install it. Installation process is also very similar like other softwares, very easy. Okay, and just select your location where you want to save the software. So once you download it, open it. So I have like this folder created on my desktop, QGIS 3.10. I am opening this QGIS 3.10 with GRASS. So if you want to enable the tools of GRASS, then only you can open it. Otherwise, the GRASS tools will not be enabled to us if we open this version. So I am opening with GRASS. So this will pop up. Now this layer will not be there. I have added this layer, but let's just keep it added. In your window, it will show the workspace, the browser panel, the layer panel and these toolbars. Some of these toolbars may not be visible because you may not have added the plugins. Later on we will add it as and when required. Browser panel and layers panel, if it is not visible to you, just check here, right click on this portion, and browser panel and layers panel, just check it. If it is unchecked, it will appear. Browser panel helps us to connect to various folders that are present in our system. So I have desktop folder, C drive, D drive, E drive, all of that can be connected here. I can open all my files through the browser panel. Whatever files I have opened, that will be reflected in layer panel. So layer panel is where all the layers will be there. Like GIS works in the form of layers. So whether you have opened a map or a topo sheet or something, whatever you have opened in your interface, in your workspace, this is the workspace that you are seeing. Okay, so that will be reflected here. So let's start with georeferencing. So georeferencing is something in which I assign a location to a particular data. So right now you can see that this is a topo sheet, and this topo sheet is prepared by Survey of India. Okay, and this year will also be reflected here. Okay, so I have downloaded it from Survey of India website. You can download it. It's very simple. You just go through Survey of India website and type their open series map. If it is not there, just go to the download products, and there you can see that open series map. These are the maps prepared of different locations in the country by Survey of India team, and they have prepared it at a scale of 1:50,000. So it is kind of not very fine resolution that you have, but it's okay to like begin with. And you can search your area by, like, every area has given a topo, a sheet number. Like the different areas are divided into different grids and then a sheet number is given. So you may not be knowing the sheet number, so you just have to search here. There will be an option to choose your state and district. Just click on that and search your sheet number there. Okay, so I'll select my state and district, and then I can know the sheet number. In order to download your topo sheet, these topo sheets are nothing but these are the scanned images. Okay, so you just have to download them. In order to download them, you have to create an account here. It will require your mobile number. OTP will be sent to that. Just write that OTP, type that OTP here, and then verify your email ID. And then you can, your account is created. You are good to go to download your topo sheet. Once you download that topo sheet, you should know where you have downloaded it. For example, I have downloaded it in the desktop folder, under the folder topo sheets. So what I will do is, I will just go to desktop, and then I will go to that folder where I have downloaded, and then I will load it. I'll just double click on that. It will reflect here, and that sheet, that topo sheet is loaded here. Now, since it would have taken a bit time for my system, that's why I have preloaded it while making the video. Okay, so if you are loading, it will load here. It might take a while, but it will appear. Okay, depending on what processor you are using. Again, I recommend to use i5 or plus so that the processing will be faster. You can see this is a raster image. Now, one thing that in GIS, the data we say is of two types, vector data or raster data. Raster data is in the form of images or pixels. For example, here you can see different pixels here. It is pixel data. Basically, vector data is in the form of points, lines and polygons. We'll see like how it looks like. We will create vector data from this raster data. Okay. So right now our purpose is to georeference that topo sheet. Now, what is georeferencing? First of all, you know, for example, there is some place here, Ratanpur. So when I scroll here on this topo sheet, you see here coordinates. It shows me some plus of 2219 and some minus of 2051. So basically, it's your x and y coordinate that it is showing. It's the simplest, I mean, Cartesian coordinate. But we do not want that. We want to know where on earth it is located. So I need to know the latitude and longitude. Longitude is basically the east or west, I mean, from eastings or eastings of that area. And latitude will be the in the form of north or south. So I want to know that what is the exact location on earth by specifying the lat and long of that area. So instead of this, I need to know the lat long of that area. So you have to georeference it in order to do that. I mean, in order to know where on earth it is located, so that your system will also be knowing that where it is located, you have to georeference it. Now, that we will see in the next video correct procedure of georeferencing. But this video was just an introduction on how to download the software and how to install it, and then how to download the topo sheet from Survey of India website. One more thing that you should see here, whatever is presented on the topo sheet related to that, all the information is given here. So here we have downloaded this random topo sheet of this area. Okay, and you can see various features present here. For example, this, what is this blue one, what is this green, what is this one in brown. All the information is available here. You can just go through it. Okay, these are some of the expressways, then some are the forested area, cultivated area, or a village boundary, or there are some religious places here, or some hospitals or basic amenities are there, or some airport is there. Like that, you can get various information. In order to georeference this topo sheet, you have to choose any 4 or any 6 points, and then you can do that. We have to just give the locations of these 4 corners, because that is what is available. Like you see, for this location, this corner, the lat long is available to me. So I'll just enter this information and my entire topo sheet will be georeferenced. I will quickly show you how to georeference in the next video. If you have understood this, if you got some idea, then do let me know. If you have any kind of confusion, then just put it in the comment section. Okay, and next video we'll see georeferencing. Thank you.